is a physiological process. But sometimes something happens. So if you are ready, now we jump into the immune system in inflammatory conditions. Okay, these are the concentration of interleukins, you know, mediators of the immune system function, in homeostasis, in healthy conditions. All of the cytokines are in physiological concentration. When I say physiological concentration, do I mean grams?
No.
No. Milligrams?
No.
Micrograms?
No.
Nanograms?
No.
Who said yes?
No.
No.
Picograms? Yes. Femtograms?
Yes.
When something happens in the body, for instance, because of a trauma, onset of inflammation, trauma, or virus, bacteria, this concentration, look, disappear, and our immune system, in order to protect himself, start producing some red interleukins, TH1 interleukins, too much. And they are, and you must remember them, interleukin 1, interleukin 6, TNF-alpha. And if the pathology is based on autoimmune disorders, interleukin 17. And why these patients have an overexpression of this? Because unfortunately, they have a deficiency of the anti-inflammatory cytokines. The most important, interleukin 10, interleukin 4, TGF-beta. Since the patient doesn't have by himself enough of these anti-inflammatory cytokines, that the moment we have to provide, where is Gunaflam? The medication to restore the physiological concentration, okay, in homeostasis. They are regulatory therapies, the deep sense of a biological therapy. Okay, if you like the image of the balance, this is the immune system of your patients with inflammatory diseases. Interleukin 1, 6, TNF-alpha, and 17 upregulated, and unfortunately, the good ones that can be also bad ones if super overexpressed, TGF-beta, interleukin 10, and interleukin 4 down. And this is the chronobiology. This is absolutely important, my friend. If we will be able to understand the scheme, we have the physiology in our hands. Look at the chronobiology of a physiological inflammation. Onset, which is the trigger of inflammation? Interleukin 1. It's called interleukin 1, exactly for that. What happens if I have a trauma in my knee? Boom. The nervous termination understand that something happened. PNEI crosstalk. They inform the immune system and say, hey, please produce more interleukin 1. Why? Because I want inflammation in that moment. Interleukin 1 produced by macrophage is attract in the area of the trauma and start the inflammation in that tissue. But you can see, this is absolutely important, interleukin 1 goes up and physiologically goes down. The, we say, hemivita, half-life, it's very short. We want inflammation in terms to defend our body. So immediately after interleukin 1 beta, we start producing TNF-alpha. Even TNF-alpha goes up, and then, if you have a good PNEI system, goes down. The last interleukin produced in the inflammatory process is interleukin 6 that goes up and then goes down. If you have a good PNEI system, all the three pro-inflammatory cytokines, interleukin 1, TNF-alpha, interleukin 6, goes down because interleukin 10 and TGF-beta, our natural anti-inflammatory cytokines, goes up. So you can see that in this moment, they cross each other. The bad ones goes down, the good ones goes up. Unfortunately, when you have a strong trigger, I don't know, a big trauma or a big infections, interleukin 10 and TGF-beta by themselves physiologically are not enough to downregulate interleukin 1-beta, TNF-alpha, and interleukin 6. You have the persistency of the pro-inflammatory cytokines. Once again, interleukin 1, TNF-alpha, interleukin 6. So you have the picture of the silent killer. 70% of your patient come to you because of this picture. Low-grade chronic inflammation. You see that especially interleukin 6, instead of to go down, do you see that it remains up? Remaining up, destroy the tissues, chronic degenerative diseases, acute coronary syndrome. It's this bastard, eh? It's this bastard. Is it clear? Because this is a very important passage in our seminar. So, let's go deep into molecular biology mechanism of inflammation. And we have to study the single cytokines now. You remember, okay, activation of NFKB. And I want to ask you, some of you are homeopaths, yeah? Okay, which is the remedy you normally use for an inflammation due to a trauma?
Depends on the person.
Yeah, depends on the person, but the most part of person, which is the...
Oh, arnica.
Arnica montana, okay. If I ask you, now I show you how we studied these natural substances. If I ask you, as homeopath, why you prescribe arnica montana?
Because it is the most, it has the most symptoms associated.
Exactly. According to the so-called Materia Medica.
Yeah.
Because in the Materia Medica, that is the book of homeopathic pharmacology, is written that if I take a healthy man and I intoxicate him with high dosage of Arnica Montana, he show similarity, symptoms of inflammation. According to, do you remember one of the first paper? According to the hormesis effect, what is able in big quantity to provoke symptoms, in very little quantity is able to cure that symptoms. But we study in our laboratories the homeopathic substances in a different way. And this is really amazing, maybe especially for you as homeopath. Which is the active principle of Arnica Montana? Is this substance named Helenalin. It's easy to remember because you think of Helen, Helenalin. By a chemical point of view, it is a sesquiterpenic lactone. And which is the action mechanism of Helenalin? Do you remember this slide? Mm-hmm. Once again, interleukin 1. Now you know that interleukin 1 is the trigger of inflammation, the onset of inflammation. Interleukin 1 binds the receptor, and the cell involved in inflammation free in the cytoplasm this protein NFKB, a nuclear translocation factor able to penetrate the nucleus of the cell, making it to produce inflammatory mediators. Do you know how alenalin in Arnica montana works? Blocking NFKB. But this mechanism of blockage of NFKB is active only if you use in low dose or if you prefer in homeopathic dilution. So now we know exactly how some homeopathic remedies work by a molecular biology point of view. That's amazing. But this is also the sign that not always Arnica Montana, everybody knows Arnica Montana, is good in treatment of inflammatory processes. Because if alenalin, active principle of Arnica, block NFKB, not making the nucleus expressing for pro-inflammatory mediators, you understand that the use of Arnica in homeopathy or in phytotherapy makes sense only in prevention of inflammation. When a patient comes to your office with a swollen knee, the pro-inflammatory mediators already circulating or not? Yes. So if you use the only Arnica, you cannot do anything because they are already in circulation. You understand? In this way, we understand better homeopathy. Instead, when you have in an inflammation due to traumas, what we recommend is this drug. It's a multi-component drug specifically designed for orthopedicians, rheumatologists, rehabilitative medicine doctors, because it is our anti-inflammatory drug for muscles, bones, tendons, ligaments. Look, it contains Arnica, good, but it contains also the opposite cytokines able to neutralize interleukin-1, interleukin-6, TNF-alpha. So it works in prevention, Arnica, or when you already have symptoms of acute inflammation. Why? Because these are the antidotes for the pro-inflammatory cytokines. You are an homeopath, you will very appreciate the presence of hypericum, arnica of nerves, chamomilla, bellis perennis, sinfitum is called the arnica of bones. Okay, you see how the multi-component medications can act on a wide range of different symptoms. We use gonatroma in inflammation of musculoskeletal system, not apparatus, system, okay, this way. In acute symptoms, 10 drops every 30 minutes for 2-3 hours, management of acute inflammation. And then 20 drops twice a day until symptoms completely disappear. This is a great medication in sport medicine, for instance, also because no doping, so you are completely sure, no problem. Interesting, eh? But it's interesting to understand how an homeopathic remedy can work synergistically with cytokines, in this case, anti-inflammatory cytokines. So please position gonatroma as the referring anti-inflammatory medication in musculoskeletal disorders. The big accused.